welcome back to the classes here now. Here we already gave a small introduction about this decimal symbolic ripple in the previous class. Okay. Now we are going to see about the next chapter, is about the chapter 7, decimals. Decimals means after the fraction, you people are going to learn this. Means, for example, as I already said you that if the number is given 2 by 10, what you can do is you can make it to the simplest form 2 ones are 2 fives are, and you can keep it as a 1 by 5. Now this 1 by 5 fraction, if you are converting to the next answer, that next answer will be as a decimal. For example, how many cells? Or other than that, if you have a problem 9 by 2, okay, right? You cannot cancel it, right? 9 cannot be divided by 2 because 9 is not there in the tables of 2. But what you can do, you can go the nearest to the 2 tables, that is 2 for the 8, right? So 9 minus 8 is 1 left out, right? So to give the remainder 0, right away if you have a 8 by 2, if you divide, you will get the remainder 0, right? But what happens in the 9 by 2, you cannot get the remainder 0, you will get the remainder 1. But to make that remainder 0, what we have to do is, we have to keep on one decimal point. And you have to consider that decimal point as 0 to the remainder there. Then it will become a 10. Now 10 you can get in a 2 tables, that is 2 fives are 10. Then you can see that you will get the remainder 0. But whereas if this is 9, this 9, if the 4 is, sorry, this 8 is divided into 2 parts, it is 4. Right? But whereas if the 9 is divided into 2 parts, it will be as a 4.5. Right? So in this way, right? See, this is taken as a 4.5, that is, or a 4.5. Right? So to mention those half, it will be taken as a 4.5. That point will be called as a decimal. Okay? Same thing here for this 1 by 5 also, we cannot get the answer. But if you divide the fraction, 1 divided by 5, right? So 5, 1 cannot be divided by 5. What we can do is, we can take as a decimal. So nothing is possible. So first we will take a 0, then decimal, that decimal will be taken as a 0. Then if you have a 10 in 2 tables, 5 is a 10, right? So what we got is 0.2. Right? In this way, when you divide this fraction, you will get the answer. When you make that remainder zeros, that quotient will be taken as the decimal. This point will be called as a decimal. So now we people are going to see this decimal. For example, now if you go to a shop, you purchase something there, an item, okay? Or any quality of the product here. What happens? The amount will be of rupees 12 and 50 paisa. Right? So, that 12 rupees 50 paisa, how will you have to write when you pronounce? Well, when you say that, it is rupees 12 and 50 paisa. Okay? But when you write, it can be written in this way, in a decimal form. This point can be used as a decimal, right? In this way, we have seen the examples. So now we will see some more with that, how these fractions are used. So next, now these some decimals examples where we can see is, for example, liters, right? If something you have taken in a liter, liquid form, right? It can be written as a 5 liter, 60 ml, right? So if that 5 liter, 60 ml can also be shown as a 5.6 liter, okay, like that you can say there, right? When 1 is rupees, just now as I said you that, if it is 12 rupees 50 paisa, it can be written as the rupees 12.50, right? So 1 centimeters also, where you can purchase the some centimeter length cloths, okay? There also it can be used as a 5.5 centimeter. distance of 5.5 meters. Like that, okay. How you people are taking that based on that is used. 2 kilometers also. If you are going to take a journey for a certain distance there. If it is at 10 kilometers, next 250 meters will be there. So it can be written as a 1.25 kilometers, right? So in this way, and in temperatures also it is used. Like 13 degrees Celsius it is used. So here we cannot use the decimal form. It is difficult here. Because approximately people are using. But in some way, maybe people are doing the some lab work, there can be used there. Okay. Other than that, in cages also, if we purchase something, if your mother says that bring a 1.5 kilo onion, right? It can be written as a 1.5 kilo in this way. Or it can be written as a 1 kg in 500 gram, right? So or else it also can be written 1.5 kg, right? So in this way, the point what you are using in between the numbers, that point will be known as a decimal. And not only that, this decimal became the word. That word is the Latin word. That Latin word has come up from one of the places, the Latin, as a Latin, where it is known as decim. It came from the Latin word as a decim. Decim means where it is the, which is rounded up to the 10, right? Up to the mark of a 10, and they became as a decimal. How that 10 is used in this way? We will use this. We will see that. So, as I said, that is the Latin word decim, and which makes equal to 10 is the fraction way. How it is used? I will show you the examples till now that is 1/5, 2/5, 9/2, like that, right? So, when you divide, when you take that as a point, and if you make a 0, and if you make the remainder, whatever you get that portion in a decimal way, you people are finding it, right? So now the main actual form, what we are saying that here we can understand very easily and understandably is like this decimal which makes to the exact places with the 10, 100, 1000, so on. Okay. As we see in the multiplications, if any number is multiplied to the 10, it will be used to the equal number like that. Okay. So here 1 by 10, 3 by 10, 5 by 10. These kind of numbers are fractions used. So there it makes that to understand to make the decimal form easily. Right? So these kind of fractions will be called as the decimal fractions. Because why these are decimal fractions means? These are written in a fraction way. And why it is decimal fraction means? Because which are made to the up to 10. With the denominators which are made to the up to 10. Not only that, it can be taken as a 4/100 or a 6/1000 also. Whichever you take that, right? So which makes you to write it easily. For example, how these can be written, right? We will see that. And how we use in the place value system, the units, tens, hundreds, like that only, these also having their place value system with the fractions there. We will see that. So here, how these are normally the generally Indian system and international system, have you have seen, no? Like that only here. No, focus on only Indian system. So now, like that only here also we will be having the decimal numbers. These decimal numbers you have to place into the place values. How it is placed, okay? And generally you know that as a number if it is given 23. So 23 is means the 2 is in a 10 place, 3 is in a 1 place, right? So if it is given 325, right? 3 is in 100 space, 20 is in 10 space, 5 is in 1 space. Like that, you people know that how to write in the Indian system with the place values, right? So now when the numbers are given with the decimal, means those decimal numbers, how to put into the place values. Say for example, first example I have taken that 23.536. Here one more, why have read that 23.536? Because the decimal number should be read in that way only. I'll explain you that next. Now we will how to insert to the table. We will see later on in detail about that also we will see here. Okay. So first example we have is 23.536. So first example 23.536. Before that I table here, right? So decimal point comes in a center. Decimal point to the left, whatever you are writing, those are the Indian system general number. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, so on. Decimal point to the right side, whatever the numbers you people are getting now, those should be read as the numbers itself. They don't have any place values like this, ones, tens, hundreds. But they have a place values in this way. T-E-N-T-H-S. T-H-S is added as the tens, hundreds, thousands. Means 1 by 10, 1 by 100, 1 by 1000. Because those are written in a decimal. So it will be taken in a fraction way. Okay. So here you can see that 1 by 10. 1 by 10 is nothing but it will be taken as a 0.1. Like that. So this will explain you. So in that way, in a 1 by 10th place it will be taken. Means here we have don't have any units place. Directly people are taking that 1 by 10th place. The after point, whatever the first number. Second number, 1 by 100th place. And third number, 1 by 1000th. THS should be there. 1000th place. Okay. So like that. Now how to insert that in the table column? You will see that 23.536. So 23 is it. 23 means 2 digits. So here it comes. So 23. So now example number is given here. That is, I'll write the example number here. 23.536. Okay. We can see this. Because we have only 2 digits. So we don't have anything. Just put a dash. So 23 point decimal. This is a decimal point. 536. So 10th place is 536. Okay. Now next one more example is given. 12.50. So same. 12.50. This way it is inserted. Next, 305.026. So, 305.026. That we have to insert here. Okay? In this way, you have to put it in the table here. So, here you can understand that how these are written in the table. This is the place values for the decimals. Before, decimal point is a normal tens, hundreds, ones place. Okay. And after the decimal point, it is tens, hundreds, thousands place. So, you have to insert. It will be taken as 1 by 10, 1 by 100, 1 by 1000. Okay. With that, you have to write here. So, here, just I will show you the next procedure now. Before inserting to the tables, you should know the names of that. I already showed you the table names. You should know the names of that. So, it is linked to one each other there. Okay, we will see the names and how to write that and how it is read there. Okay. So, these are the numbers 1 by 10, fractions, 3 by 10, 9 by 10. Okay. These fractions will be called as a decimal fractions because we have a decim in bottom or in denominator which is rounded to the 10 here. Right? So these decimal fractions, when you are writing in the decimal fraction name, these when you have read, it is 1 by 10th, no? That will be read as a 1 tenths. It will be read as 1 tenths. Okay. This will be read as a 3 tenths. Because it is given in the decimal form. Okay, 3 tenths. So, 3 tenths of tens like that. 3 tenths. Okay. Here it is 10, 9, 9 tenths. Like that. If it is given 9 by 100, 9 hundredths. 1000, 9 thousandths. Means it will be like this. This way it is red as. If it is given 9 by 100. Okay. So, it will be red as a 9 hundredths. THS is added. If it is 3 by 1000, okay, what happens again? It will be read as a 3 thousandths. THS, the pronunciation will be slow. T thousandths, okay, like that. It is read. Okay, here these are called as the decimal fractions. These are the decimal fraction names. And these it is written in the decimal. Now later you should write in the decimal. So this can be written as a 0.1. right? 0.1. Why? See, now I'll show you here. If it is, it is given that 1 divided by 10. As already I showed you 1 divided by 5. In that, 1 divided by 10. If you do, so 10. You cannot do that because 1 is smaller. But in decimal, it is possible. So first, nothing is possible, 0. Next, to continue the calculation, we have to put a decimal point. And that decimal point brings 0 to the position of the dividend here. So 10, and now you got 10, and 10 can go into 10 tables, that is 10 ones are 10. So you can see that remainder is 0, but quotient is 0.1. That is 0.1. It is red has a 0.1 or a 0.1. Okay. So now here we have to write that 0.1. Because we have 1 by 10. But here is 3 by 10. So obviously, in the place of 1, only 3 is shifted. So you can write directly 0.3. And here it is 9 by 10. So it can be written as a 0.9. If it is 5 by 10, 0.5. 7 by 10, 0.7. Okay? Based on the number what is given in the numerator. Okay? These are the single digits. If it is double digits, 12 by 10. What happens if it is 12 by 10? Right? If the number is 12 by 10, keep the 12 as it is. How many zeros are there in the denominator? 1 zero. So, after what digits from the right, put a decimal point. It will be known as a 1.2. Okay? If it is 123 by 10, whatever you have a numerator, write that numerator as it is. In the denominator, you have a only 1 zero. So, after one number, you have to put a decimal. That is from the unit space, that is 12.3. Right? Like that only. As we saw the exercises, we will come to know this because already we have discussed this basics in your class 5th also. How these decimals are formed. Okay? So, like that only. Yes, now this is a decimal fraction. Decimal fraction names are written in this way. When it is asked, these kind of questions you prepare will be asked there. So, 1 by 10 is known as 1 tenths, 3 by 10 is 3 tenths. If it is example 12 by 10, 12 tenths. 123 by 10 is 123 tenths, like that. 123 tenths. Whatever the position is given, based on that, you have to place the values. Okay. The fraction in the decimal you are writing as a 0.1, 0.3, 0.9. So now, these decimal names also should be known to write. You have to, as we people are writing the number system, with the numbers and the words, figures and words you are using, no? Like that only in the decimal also, you should know the decimal form of writing and also the names of that. So, 0.1. So, this we can be read as a 0.1. It can be written in this way. Whereas, 0.3, 0.3 or a 0.3, 0.9, like that. What we are reading, the same thing in words also should be written in this way. Like that. If it is in this formation, what happens? 9 by 100, right? So, 1 zero, you got 1 decimal point, right? 1 number. So, here 2 zeros, put the 2 zeros and put the numerator number. 2 zeros after 2 digits. So, it becomes 0.09. So, how will you write? 0.09. Okay. Here 3 zeros are there. Put the 3 zeros. What do you have numerator? 3. Right? 3 zeros are there. So after 3 digits you have to put a decimal. Unit stands 100. After 3 digits. Here it comes. 0.003. And how will you write? 0.003. Like that only. You should not read it as 0.3. 0.003 because this 3 is in the place of 1 by 1000. This 0 is in a 1 by 10s. Sorry, 100s. This one is 1 by 10s. Here place values also measures. Don't neglect the decimals. So, you we cannot jump the decimal place values. Decimal place values also is important. So only I explained you the table earlier. Okay. So in this way, this decimal form can be written. Okay. So we will see some examples here. I show you that based on that we can understand how these decimals are used. Okay. How you people can write. So these are called as the decimal fractions, because in the denominators we have a 10, 100, 1000s. In these conditions, whatever we have, no, that will be called as the decimal fractions. These are in the decimal form. Okay. So 8 by 10, as I already said you that 1 by 10 can be written as a 0.1. So 8 by 10 can be written as a 0.8 or a 0.8. And not only with that, in the numerator whatever you have that you write 8. And before that one decimal, because 1 0. And now also I have a 7 here, so I'll keep a 7. Okay. So you can see that in the denominator I have 2 zeros. I'll keep 2 zeros. 2 zeros means after 2 digits. So after 2, 7, 0. From the unit place after 2 digits. Okay. Now 5 by 1000. 3 zeros are there. 1, 2, 3. And the numerator I have a 5. So I'll keep a 5. So 1, 2, 3 digits are there. 1, 2, 3. After 3 digits, 3 zeros, 3 digits. So unit stands 100, because it is in 5 by 1000 place. Don't get thousands place confusion here. 3 zeros, 3 place values. Okay. So now 37 by 10 is there. So write the first 37 as it is. And we have only 1 0 in the denominator. So 1 decimal point. So it is 1 decimal point. Okay, this is not there, don't get confused. So 3.7. Next, we have a 49. So write that 49 as it is, but we have a 2 zeros, 2 digits. So 1, 2. So nothing is there before point, we can keep it as a 0. This doesn't have a value, so just to represent the number, decimal number, we can put a 0 there. So 965. Keep that 965 numerator as it is. In the denominator, 3 zeros are there, 1, 2, 3. So, after 3 numbers, the decimal point, and nothing is there, so you can keep it as 0. 0.965. After decimal, you should read as a number. A digit.